When I wake up in the morning, I start hurting because the pain is intense. My ankles are swollen all the time. My knees are constantly in pain. My body is pretty stiff because I haven't moved all night. So it's hard for me to walk. And I have to take a lot of breaks. I try not to do a whole lot of moving around because sometimes when I do too much walking, I break out in hives on my legs. I hate it. I'm just completely trapped in this body. But being my size, I really have to try to stay as clean as possible because of all the folds in my skin. Bathing myself is one of the hardest things I do. It hurts. And it's hard to reach around my body. But if I don't, I could get terrible rashes that could turn into open sores. Every day, I'm just praying that this body doesn't give out. But there's already so much I can't do on my own. And my weight has become a burden to my family.
Kaya!
Can you come to my legs? Once I get out the shower, my daughter comes in and she'll clean out the back of my legs because my arms are too short to reach.
Mom, she tries to do everything. She tries not to be lazy. She tries to do a lot, but she can't.
You call her. That's a lot. She is a 40-year-old woman in an 11-year-old's body. And it is embarrassing for her to see me like this. She shouldn't have to do it. And I feel horrible that I have to ask her to do something that I should be able to do myself. Because of my weight, we have adjusted as much as we can to make this work, but it's progressively getting worse. I'm existing, I'm not living.
When I see my mom hurting a lot, it makes me feel bad. It's really heartbreaking and sad. I don't know what I would do if she died or so, if she was stuck in the bed or something. I would hardly be healthy.
At this point, we need something drastic to happen to get us back to where I'm the parent and they're just kids. If I don't do something drastic, something now, I'll die at an early age. I need to be here for my kids. Nobody else is here. They don't have anything else.
Keys, please. We're a close-knit family, and I definitely want my sister to get help. I've seen her struggles throughout her life with her weight, and I definitely want to give her anything that she needs. So I don't want her to have to stress out about the drive down. I could do all of that and let her concentrate on what she needs to do.
Seeing Yukaya do ballet was a wake-up call. I have to get help. But this is going to be a hard drive in a car for 8 hours. I know for certain that if I don't get my weight under control, inevitably my life will be shortened. But my biggest fear is that I will drive all the way to Houston and he'll say that there's nothing he can do for me because I feel like this is my last shot.
You're gonna have to exercise. How you feel about that?
I don't wanna do it, but I know I'm gonna have to.
By the time you go to work and then you deal with the kids, when is there gonna be time for you to do it?
Well, don't push. Because if you push, I'm going to push back.
I feel like this is make or break for me.
If Dr. Now doesn't think that I'm a good candidate, I don't know what my other options are.
Ms. Wells?
I'm really nervous. I haven't checked my weight in years. And I have no idea what I'm about to learn about myself. A 6'10 is not what I wanted to see. I know I need to do something, and I need to do it now.
Hello. How y'all doing? I'm Dr. Jordan.
I'm Cynthia Wells.
All right, nice to meet you.
I'm Clarence. I'm Cynthia's brother.
How you doing?
All right.
So you weigh 610 pounds. Tell me about your eating habits.
My weight has gotten out of control, and I have some pretty unhealthy eating habits. I eat in excess. If, you know, if it's something that I really enjoy, I eat a lot of it.
So you don't get full?
I get full, but if it's something I enjoy, I'll just keep eating.
All right. Anybody else in your family is overweight?
Everybody in my family is overweight.
He's not.
He is. He's probably the smallest one.
All right. Are you active at all?
I'm a teacher, so I have to be active for that.
Okay. Do you eat at home?
Yes.
Who is in the house beside you?
My 5 children.
So you cook for everybody and for yourself, too?
Yes.
Cynthia is over 600 pounds, and it's quite remarkable that she can take care of 5 children at that weight. But she's making food for a large household, which means there is a lot of food constantly in that house. So she's around food all day long. That's going to be a very big challenge for her to change her eating habit. You're a mom, and you have a responsibility to your kids. So from this point on, we are going to make changes in your eating habit. I got some school material so you know how the homework goes. You need to stick with the low-carb diet and eat only 3 times a day and no snacking. This will be a 1,200-calorie-a-day diet. What is your ability to do exercise and walk?
I really don't do a lot of walking.
Or how much you can walk before you feel tired and give up?
Maybe like from here to your waiting room.
That's it?
It's about as much as she wants to do.
Okay, so you're 42. And the likelihood that you're gonna make this 50 are not very good if you keep this up. So if you wanna be around for your kids, you need to start making changes now. Okay. I want you to walk, rest.
Okay.
How much you walk on Monday is gonna be important. If we stick with this diet,
okay,
you should be able to lose 30 pounds in 1 month. And if you can make these changes, weight loss surgery could be an option for you down the road.
Okay.
This next month will show me whether or not Cynthia can get control of her home dynamic and commit to this change, or she is unable or unwilling to do what she needs. Okay, I'll see you all later.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Cynthia is going to have to realize just how hard this is going to be for her.